We are what about the 1 year? Well, I should have asked Jim about this yesterday, the 1 year anniversary of the Edward Snowden revelations. But a lot of people are concerned about the privacy of their stuff.
Yep.
And, you know, this is just one part of it. We asked a privacy and security expert, am I saying this right? Seecrypt group.
Seecrypt.
Yeah.
Yep.
Because I, you know, obviously we've talked a lot about all this stuff and what you can do. People are more and more concerned about security just in your daily conversations, right? In your texts.
Mm-hmm.
Mornay Walters, I think I'm saying that right. Hey, Mornay, good morning.
Very good morning to you, Stephanie.
Good morning. So tell us about, I mean, my listeners I know are a lot, have been concerned about this for a long time in terms of privacy of phone conversation. You guys, tell us what you do, because a lot of people are saying, like, how can you protect your stuff? And what you guys is encrypt, you do encryption, right?
That's correct. We started many years ago of providing communication security for a small group of people, essentially in government and high-profile net individuals, that could effectively afford a solution. But what we've seen in the market back then, and I'm talking 5-6 years ago, is that there was a constant erosion of privacy and security.
Mm-hmm.
And the internet and the communication and social media applications that was designed and built and given to us, many of these are for free, was never built for security, let alone for privacy. And it came to us, you know, and we made a decision that saying is that it's not just the people in power and those that can afford the solution that needs protection, but in fact, everybody should be able to have the solution. And a decision was made 2 years ago to take the knowledge that we've had and make this more accessible for everybody around the world. And this is where Seecrypt was born, out of the necessity from people like yourselves and, in fact, anybody around the world that wants privacy. But privacy cannot be achieved throughout security. You know, Larry Page said that from the founder from Google exactly the way. You can't get privacy without security.
Well, and that's the thing that, you know, a lot of us are you know, just asking basically is, you know, can we actually protect ourselves from, you know, let's say keeping our phone conversations private? And how does your technology do that? I know I've heard it's military-grade technology, because I think a lot of us feel like we're no match for the government. Like, whatever kind of stuff we get, you know, to secure ourselves is not going to be enough.
Well, very quickly, how it works is that essentially it's an application-to-application and end-to-end encryption. And the first thing that you do is when you install the application, what we've done is we've taken away the complexities that is associated with encryption and security. And you ask anybody today who's tried to set up security or encrypted email, and they will tell you it's a nightmare. Mm-hmm. Now, when it comes to instant messaging and voice encryption, it's pretty much the same. And what we wanted to do is make sure that you can download the app, and in 2 minutes flat, you should be able to make your first call or send a message to another Seecrypt user. And essentially what happens is that after you've installed the app, you create your own private and public keys on your phone. Now, those are unique to you. We don't know it. No one else knows it. And we take data from around sensors, audio, the vibrations in the phone, and all kinds of different sensors. We make a massive number up, and we give that as a key. Now, that key is as we call it, the 2048-bit massive key that is used in their system. Now we've got one part done. Your contact on the other side, let's call it Alice and Bob, is got done exactly the same. And when you contact for the first time, you exchange keys. But when you send a message, we create a second key, which we call a throwaway key.
Mm-hmm.
So when you send a message, just say, hi, how are you? I'm good. That's three messages and three different keys.
I'm technologically impaired, so everything you're saying is like Greek to me.
No, it makes sense to me.
All I care about is that it works.
Yeah. Yes.
You know what, Mornay?
Imagine this, Stephanie, is you have for every letter that you post, you need a different password to open it.
Right.
And what we wanted to allow people to do is that most people, encryption is very difficult to break itself, any good encryption. But it's the way people manage keys. And Seecrypt is all about keys. So if we can manage the keys and make the keys as random and as multiple as possible,
mm-hmm.
it becomes virtually impossible for any person or any organization, be it private, government, to intercept and decrypt the content. And
Mornay,
we provide you security.
You know, it's interesting. Obviously, we've talked a lot on the show about the Snowden revelations, but you know the one that I'm hearing more among my friends lately is the Donald Sterling thing. I think people are, like, very concerned about what if this or that private conversation of mine got public, because all of us, I'm sure, have said things that we right. wouldn't want public or texted things or you know, who knows what. So, you know, I think the technology is probably, you know, more important now than ever, right?
That's correct. But also we have to think of our the younger generation that is out there. Now, and I always say this in conversations, that when I was young and I did the stupid things, there was no internet.
yes, thank God.
You know, so but, you know, as a parent today, I've got, you know, the kids have tablets. They have access to all this information. We're all young and we all do stupid things. These things these days get recorded and stay forever with us.
Forever,
yeah. There's no
right.
way. Yes, it will stay with us forever. Once Google and the big search engines get hold of it, it's there forever.
Yeah.
Now you're 21 and you do some stupid things. 30 years later or even 10 years later, you run for office or you join a prestigious club or a
right.
business, and your past comes and haunts you.
So yeah.
At which stage?
Oh, I could have been president. I could have been president before the internet, Mornay.
Exactly.
I know what you're saying.
So, and this is the first problem. So I think what we have to do is we have to have the tools in place to give us privacy and security. But the owners and everything else remains with us as individuals and users. We need to treat the internet with respect, and we need to treat the internet like the public, just like I'm on Times Square.
Yep.
I'm not going to do stupid things on Times Square, and because it's a public area.
Right.
So the internet should be treated with respect.
Yep.
And if you're going to rant and make comments in a public forum, then you should treat it like you're doing it from the roof.
Absolutely. Mornay, we are short on time. Thank you so much.